So then what needs to change about our education system so that we're not stifling late bloomers?
I think there are many good examples from around the world of things we might try and at least run experiments on. For example, Finland starts kids later in school, age 7. And in fact, it highly discourages teaching kids formally writing and reading and I think math. It's not going to tell parents they can't do it, but they really believe that there's more to be gained by letting kids be kids when their brains are most plastic. That's how they develop independence. That's how they develop, you know, their own mind. That's how they develop their curiosity. You don't want to squelch it. You don't want to ask these little kids to trade their curiosity for some determined focus, you know, all worshiping at the altar of test scores and super grades and great college admissions 15 years later. I think I'd like to see a revival of the skilled trades track in public high schools. Only 1 out of 20 public high schools even offers what we used to call shop class. But there's so many fascinating skilled trade jobs out there made popular by Mike Rowe and his Dirty Jobs and others. You know, welding and HVAC and jobs like that, they're becoming pretty technologically sophisticated. They pay pretty darn well. I mean, kids with 18 months of education can make six-figure salaries. And it's a great track, and you're not trapped in that. You know, if you decide it's too dirty or a dangerous job, then you can always go back to school. Well, consider somebody who decided to be a welder at 18, and then at age 28, no longer, you know, could see that maybe it's a little wearing on the body and decided to become a civil engineer, that through the course of welding was exposed to a lot of big construction projects and thought that would be cool. And now, you see, when they go to college, they know what they want to do. They're probably not going to overpay for their education. They're going to do it through community college. They're going to do it through however they can do it. They want to do it fast. They want to do it with a sense of where they want to be at the end of that. And who wouldn't want that kind of an employee? Because here you have somebody with a college degree in civil engineering who also knows what it's like to get hands dirty building things. That's a great skill. So I think we need to revive the skilled trade track. I've become a strong believer in gap years. Why rush off to college right away? Why not go on a two-year adventure or a church mission or something like that? As long as the parent isn't writing checks to support the kid in 2 years of endless partying, a lot of good can come from taking gap years. You can also take a gap year, as many do, between the sophomore and junior years. I'm not a member of the Church of Latter-day Saints, but I'm an admirer of the concept of the Mormon mission, where these kids after their sophomore year go out and take a two-year mission and then come back and they're more mature. They graduate at age 24 or 25. I think we should at least open a discussion about mandatory military service, and if you're opposed to military service, we'll call it civilian service. So there are two tracks for people. The countries that have that, like Israel, Switzerland, Singapore, and others, tend to have much better outcomes for their young adults. Less drinking, less crime, all those kinds of things that are kind of rampant in places, similarly affluent countries that don't have it, like the UK and the US. So I'm a big believer in community colleges. Since colleges are so expensive and since you can always transfer, why not for the first 2 years kind of explore what you want to be at a low cost? So I think there are multiple tracks that we ought to consider that I would collectively say are best practices from around the world that maybe we should try them out at the state level or even the municipal level and see what the outcomes are. Maybe they won't scale up to a country of 330 million as diverse as we are. Maybe we're just too big and unwieldy for them to work. But they could work and the benefits would be immense.